Hi everyone. Welcome back to our YouTube channel. Today we will talk about pre-stress losses in post-tension pre-stressed concrete. This presentation is prepared by City, and before that, please help us to like, subscribe and share our channel. Today we will talk about two types of pre-stress losses: immediate losses and time-dependent losses. Immediate losses consist of friction loss, WEDGE loss and elastic shortening loss. For time-dependent losses, it consists of shrinkage loss, creep loss and steel relaxation loss. To understand pre-stress losses further, please refer to the force versus time graph for a simple explanation. To start, we will stress the tendon up to 75% UTS. After achieving its stressing force and when the tendon has been locked, immediate losses in the strands start to happen. Immediate losses is not time dependent, and you can see the drop of force in the graph as an immediate action. After immediate losses, time dependent losses happen as shown in the graph. In other words, it is known as long-term losses. What is friction loss? Friction happens when the strand is straightened up during the pulling of strand and sliding against the side of duct. The friction causes the force inside the strand to gradually reduce from jacking point to the end of tendon. Frictional resistance consists of two components. First is tendon wobble effect. Second is tendon curvature effect. What is tendon wobble effect? Here is the intended tendon profile, which is the design tendon profile. However, after laying the tendon on top of bar chairs, the tendon will naturally have a wobble effect. Once the strand is stressed, the force travels along the tendon following the shape of the tendon. Since the tendon is curved, friction occurs due to angular change of profile. Alpha x shown here is the angular change from one point to another point. Refer to the formula shown for friction loss. We need to identify the mu and k value from the tensioning system supplier and calculate the summation of angular change. Here, we can find the loss of force due to friction. What is wedge in loss? To retain pre-stressing force after pulling, the strand is anchored using a wedge and barrel system. During the process of developing a full grip on the strand, the anchoring system will have a slip in wedge and barrel. The wedge in is set according to the supplier's tensioning system. Typically, the value is set to 6 mm in design. You can see here that during the removal of pulling force, the wedge along with the strand is locked tightly against the barrel. This is a pre-stress force versus tendon length graph. From the jacking force, the force is gradually reduced in a slope due to friction loss. However, after wedging occurs in a locking system, the force is further reduced along the affected length, L prime. Refer to the formula shown for wedging loss. We need to identify the L prime due to wedge in and the tendon slope of force. From there, we can find the loss of force due to wedge in at anchorage and in any length within the L prime. What is elastic shortening loss? Shortening of concrete is due to compressive force transmitted from pulling force to the member through anchorages. First tendon will have no loss during stressing. However, for subsequent tendon stressing, it will create new shortening to the concrete from the additional force. Thus, new concrete shortening will cause the first tendon to suffer a loss in force. No loss due to elastic shortening if all tendons are stressed simultaneously. Animation here illustrate the loss of force due to elastic shortening. You refer to the formula shown for elastic shortening loss. We need to identify the strain of concrete by adopting a 0.5 factor, which takes into account the averaging effect of several tendons that were stressed in sequence. Here, we can find the loss of force due to elastic shortening. What is concrete shrinkage loss? Contraction due to drying of concrete creates shrinkage strain in the member. Shrinkage strain causes the strand to lose its force. Main factors affecting drying shrinkage is types of aggregate, original water content in the concrete mix, effective age of transfer of pre-stress, effective section thickness, and ambient relative humidity. This is the drying shrinkage of normal weight concrete for engineers to refer. From here, you can get the shrinkage strain value to adopt in the next formula. Refer to the formula shown for shrinkage loss. We need to identify the strain of concrete due to shrinkage. Here, we can find the loss of force due to shrinkage. What is concrete creep loss? It is a time-dependent deformation due to permanent force. The concrete creep strain causes the strand to lose its force. Main factors affecting concrete creep is age of concrete at first loading, magnitude of stress at first loading, mixed proportions of the concrete during loading, effective section thickness, and ambient conditions. This is creep coefficient graph for engineer to refer. From here, you can get creep coefficient value to adopt in the next formula. Refer to the formula shown for concrete creep loss. We need to identify the strain of concrete due to creep using the creep coefficient from the previous graph. Here, we can find the loss of force due to creep. Lastly, what is steel relaxation loss? Relaxation of steel creates a loss of stress with time in the strand. The amount of relaxation depends on the type of strand and applied initial stress. Refer to the formula shown for steel relaxation loss. The table above is for low relaxation steel. Here, you can get a 1000-hour relaxation value and relaxation factor to adopt in the formula. Then, we can find the loss of force due to relaxation of steel. The above references were in the preparation for this presentation. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and following us. To our new viewers, please subscribe to our channel for more videos. Find out more about Design Connection in the video description. Bye.